hear a lot about these militant Muslims and how radical Islam is, but what about those who say, you know what, we're moderate?
That's a very good question. Muhammad divided the world into two halves. He called them houses. One is the House of Islam, Dar al-Islam, and the other is the House of War, Dar al-Harb, H-A-R-B. And so the whole non-Muslim world is at war because it's transitioning to become the House of Islam. So a faithful Muslim sees the world as Muslim and going to be Muslim. Now, the word Islam means submission. It actually means the opposite of the word freedom and liberty. In America, we're big on freedom and liberty. Pray what you want, dress the way you want, eat what you want, so forth. Islam, it controls how you dress, it controls what you eat, it controls how the women are supposed to, you know, be accompanied by a male relative when they leave the house. And so the word Islam means submission to the will of Allah. And a faithful Muslim thinks there will be world peace when the whole world has submitted to the will of Allah. So where you and I think world peace is where different groups that don't believe the same thing just learn how to get along, a faithful Muslim thinks there will be world peace when there's world Islam. When Islam's enemies are defeated, there's peace. There's nobody left to fight. Now, a moderate Muslim thinks the world will submit to Allah later. Maybe at the end of the world, or maybe it's even figurative. And since it's so far off and so hard to understand, just get along with the infidels, the kafirs, you know. And that's fine. That type of Muslim can live very comfortably in a free democratic society and participate in our regular life in America. But the fundamental Muslim, on the other hand, thinks the world is submitting to Allah now. And they're very excited and they want to help make it happen. So the dilemma for the West is the more the West bends over backwards in unprecedented ways to show acceptance and tolerance of Islam, like having Muslims praying on our Capitol lawn, like issuing Islamic postage stamps, like having a president, you know, whose middle name is Hussein, who's Muhammad's grandson, the first male descendant of Muhammad. I mean, this is unprecedented. What is the moderate Muslim supposed to think? They begin to rethink, say, wait a second, maybe the world is actually submitting to Allah now. So they gravitate from the future peaceful camp into the fundamental now camp, which is the violent camp. Sort of like your alma mater, your high school. I mean, if they have a losing season, you know, season after season, you become a passive fan. You become peaceful, you don't get excited, right? But if they get on a roll and they win the districts and the regionals and they're headed toward the state playoffs, you get excited. You pull the old jersey out of the bottom drawer, you put it on, you call up some friends, maybe even buy tickets, pack out the stadium, and some paint their bodies and put cheese on their head if they're in Wisconsin. I mean, as their team advances, there's enthusiasm. That's the enthusiasm that's being experienced right now in Islam. When they see these unprecedented things like Nancy Pelosi going over to Syria and putting on the hijab, the Muslim veil. When they see that we have a school in California, Contra Costa County, California, had their students dress up as Muslims for a week, take Muslim names, learn Islam's five pillars, memorize verses of the Quran. The ACLU did nothing. I mean, imagine if they dressed up as Bible characters and memorized 316. The ACLU would have a fit. And so as the Muslims see this, Harvard shuts down one of its gymnasiums to have Sharia gym practice. This is unprecedented. Sort of like for centuries, Christians and Jews understood the verses in the Old Testament about Israel being regathered together again. But maybe those verses would be fulfilled at the end of the world, or maybe it's even figurative, or the church took the place of Israel or whatever. But then all of a sudden in 1948, boom, there's Israel. And what happened in Jewish and Christian circles? A lot of enthusiasm and excitement that maybe these verses are coming true. That's the excitement that's being experienced right now in Islam. When, you know, Minnesota puts Muslim foot baths in their airports, and when we have a Muslim be our U.S. ambassador to the United Nations, Zalmay Khalilzad and so forth. So we're facing this dilemma that the more we bend over backwards in unprecedented ways to show acceptance, it's having this byproduct of causing a lot of moderate Muslims to get more enthused about their faith, gravitate toward the fundamental area, and that's the area that produces the violence. And so it's a time that we as Christians need to pray and to love the person and realize that God does have a plan and God does want them to come to faith. But it also is an encouragement for us to realize what's valuable in our culture and decide whether or not we want to preserve this culture, which I believe we should.